What goes down here may be the key to stopping the next pandemic.
Influenza A, influenza B, H1N1, monkeypox, COVID, of course. That was the first sort of pathogen that we started looking for.
This is an open drain. More than a third of all sewage in India flows here, and testing it through environmental surveillance could save millions of lives.
When I told my kids for the first time that I was testing sewage, they were disgusted. At the same time, they were fascinated. It works beautifully in lower income sections of urban areas, where people's poop converges.
It's the first time that we see something that belongs to everyone, and our people can actually protect themselves.
Environmental surveillance has a huge potential because there are so many people who don't have access to regular testing.
Poop is a great equalizer. Everybody poops, whether they're rich, they're poor.
It's not just important for India, but for everyone.
To solve the world's most pressing problems, we need to trust those closest to the challenge. These are the solutions that make our world a better place for everyone. This is Rethinking Possible.
For anybody who walks around Bangalore, the first thing that you do see are the open drains. I don't think there are too many high-income countries with open drains. I would be very surprised, in fact. I'm Varsha Shridhar. I am a molecular virologist and a biotechnologist. In the 60s, polio wastewater surveillance was basically the first large-scale public health wastewater surveillance. But after that, there hasn't really been any sort of ongoing research into what can wastewater be used to test for.
It wasn't until the urgency of the COVID-19 pandemic that interest in wastewater surveillance renewed. And after one study showed that underground wastewater surveillance could serve as an early warning system, it prompted the question, could it work in open drains too?
Short one, take one, marking.
My name is Dr. Angela Chaudhuri. I serve as Chief Catalyst of Swasti. It's a global public health organization that serves some of the most marginalized populations. In March 2020, already many people were affected by COVID. We really wanted to know if open drains held some clues for us. So we had to prove for ourselves that this experiment would actually work.
I would not say we were winging it, but it was definitely not something that we had tested before.
We literally had a fishing rope with a plastic bottle tied at the end, and we just kept doing that.
We were just like, put the bucket into the water and carry it to the lab. But when we saw that first positive, I think we both freaked out. There was this kind of shriek, it's positive.
With the backing of Swasti and a host of other health-interested collaborators, they created the Precision Health Platform, a public dashboard where wastewater test results could be viewed in real time and could inform communities to know an outbreak was imminent 7 days before hospitals started filling up.
This meant that government administrators could warn the hospitals. They could plan human resources, they could plan their staff, and they could plan for hospital beds.
Initially, I was not able to see the connection between what I thought would be an isolated research finding to a public health response that could actually lead to some kind of an actionable insight.
The moment there's a spike, our data was better than the...
Angela is an extremely experienced public health professional, and so she was able to see the next steps forward.
It all starts here, with the sewage collection. Through barcodes, they track where each sample is scooped up.
All these sites are geotagged. This is the bottle of the sample which was taken from this particular site. This represents a population of around 500 households on average.
Samples are then taken to Dr. Varsha's lab, where RNA is extracted and tested for various pathogens. Then that information is transmitted to the dashboard corresponding to each 500 household section of the city. It puts everyone, no matter of status or wealth or location, on a level playing field.
It's a lot about governance. Why shouldn't we have access to information like that? The platform itself is setting new standards in what should be a public good. I would like to know what risks are out there in a way that I understand so I can take care of myself.
People who live in slums in India often don't have access to proper healthcare. So with this information available to community leaders, health authorities, and journalists, it can be disseminated throughout communities, delivering on this massive public health challenge.
If they don't fall sick because they're protected by masks and other interventions, then they're able to lead their livelihoods without any concerns.
What I'm most excited about the future is the integration of environmental signals with community clinical data for conditions like antimicrobial resistance, tuberculosis, and new and emerging pathogens.
In addition to expanding their testing to other pathogens or compounds of public health interest, the Precision Health platform is also expanding across India. Their framework is available for any place with open drains.
We started with Bangalore. Now we're in 5 cities across India with interests from Cambodia and Philippines as well. Our dream is to see this scale up in as many cities as possible so that the cities are better prepared.
The years since 2020 have only sort of underscored that we are a bunch of slightly weird people who like to test gross things. I think what sort of drives me in this is the constant need for tinkering. We have evolved from a biomedical lab into a public health action on the ground.
Scientists, people who hold political posts, artists, all of these people came together to deliver health outcomes for some of the most marginalized people. Precision Health platform has shown me local innovations can help us plan and prepare for the next pandemic, perhaps even the next disasters that are going to hit us.